Hey guys, it's Kevin, and this video is about nothing. I'm just kidding, it's the Nothing Phone 2. I'm really excited for this one because I haven't reviewed a new phone from a fairly new company since starting my YouTube channel. I was expecting too much from the Phone 2 since it doesn't have all the fancy bells and whistles that flagships have, but I was wrong. And it's because of one thing that differentiates this phone from the rest, and its design. But first, I want to go over the unboxing experience because that itself is quite unique. Depending on the Phone 2 color you choose, there'll be a color matching box of either dark gray or white. The box is a pretty big square and thin compared to the other ones we've seen. And there's a pull tab that wraps around the entire box. I wish there was a different way to open it since it ruins the box. The white holder inside opens like a book, and it's very clean and Apple-like. Inside we get the Phone 2, safety information and warranty card, a transparent SIM tray ejector, and a transparent cable. It's only the ends though. And that's it, there's nothing left in the box. The Phone 2 starts at $599 all the way up to $799. If you're interested, I'll leave a link to it in the description box below. Overall, I really enjoyed the whole unboxing, and it's a nice touch that the accessories match Nothing aesthetics. Nothing phones are new to me since I never used the original Phone 1. I've only seen pictures and videos about it, but the Phone 2 looks very similar, which is not necessarily a bad thing. It still stands out compared to the Galaxy and iPhones of the world. The Phone 2 comes in two colors, dark gray and white. I usually go for a darker tone phone, but I think Nothing phones look better in white. Plus, the fingerprints and scratches aren't as visible. I've been using the Phone 2 for the past 2 weeks, and I really like the design. There's flat aluminum sides all the way around with several antenna lines. Power buttons on the right, and volume buttons on the left. The pill-shaped buttons look like the iPhone, but I noticed they're not centered in the middle of the frame. The bottom has a SIM card tray, USB-C port, and the correct speaker location. When I'm using the phone, my pinky finger rests on the left side, so it's not blocked like on the S23 Ultra. There are also mics on the top and bottom, and the back has a signature transparent look. You can see all the different parts underneath like the wireless charging coil, lights, screws, and even text. They're painted over, but it still looks really cool. The back is made from Gorilla Glass 5 and is slightly curved unlike last year, so it feels comfortable in the hand. This is the first time I've seen a phone with a curved back and flat sides. It's about the same size as the S23 Ultra and the 14 Pro Max, but it's a lot lighter at just 201 grams. This phone is only IP54, so it has limited dust and water resistance. Design is great and all, but Nothing also set out to make the Phone 2 sustainable, with recycled materials across the board from the frame, copper foil, plastic parts, and circuit board. Even the box contains plastic-free packaging. Nothing did a great job on the design, but if the back were matte, that'd be even better. Not only is the hardware unique, but the software as well. The Phone 2 is running Nothing OS 2.0, which is basically stock Android plus a few tweaks here and there. The first thing you'll notice is on the lock screen. Nothing has this dot matrix font throughout the OS. The time, date, and weather have this dot pattern that looks very clean. Two lock screen shortcuts can be set at the bottom, but there are a ton of options you can choose from. Then there's the new lock screen widgets. It's only Nothing widgets, so again, not a ton of options. You can add different clock widgets like analog, digital, or world, an interactive quick setting, or the weather. Next up is the home screen. Nothing has an icon pack that changes every app icon to monochrome. And I mean every icon. Just look at my app drawer. Other Android phones have tried this, but there's always a few that stand out. Some people will probably think it looks basic and boring, but the idea is not to get sucked in that digital life. I can be like, oh, I need to order something from Amazon. So I open the app and place the order, and as soon as I close it, I need to pause for a bit. I'm not tempted to open another app because there's no color at all. Nothing's home screen widgets are well designed. The same clock, weather, and quick settings can be found here. I really like these interactive quick settings since I don't need to swipe down to open notifications and do some hand gymnastics. Even though it's called Nothing OS, most of the apps have that stock Android look. Messages is the same, phone is the same, settings is basically the same, but you get the idea. As far as I can tell, the only apps that Nothing touch is the camera, recorder, and weather. There's nothing bad with stock apps, but Nothing should expand their dot matrix design to more apps to make it unique. Nothing OS is now my favorite non-stock version of Android. It's very clean and minimal, and there's no bloatware. The transparent back looks cool and all, but it also serves another purpose with the glyph interface. Nothing added all these LEDs on the back, which light up depending on the task. The original Phone 1 mostly had solid lines, but Nothing broke them up for this year's model into 11 different sections. They're bright and white, and there are 33 different zones. 16 of these zones are actually in this one strip just above the wireless charging coil, and it allows for more precise control instead of a solid zone. In settings, there's a glyph timer, so you can see a live progress bar as the time counts down. This zone will also adjust when you increase or decrease the volume, and third-party apps like Uber can take advantage of the glyph progress. This strip is the only one that has precise controls, all the others are solid lights, but some of them do serve a different purpose. This one in the corner is the essential glyph, so when you receive a notification from one of your important apps, this light will stay on until you read it. The exclamation mark at the bottom activates with Google Assistant, or if you wiggle your phone while it's charging. And this red light turns on when you start recording. And let's not forget about the Glyph interface syncing with a built-in ringtone, notification sounds, or Glyph Composer. The Glyph interface looks cool, but it's only useful if you have your phone face down. Most of the time, I have my phone face up, so the screen will light up when I receive a notification. I don't see myself using it too much, but it does make the phone unique. The design alone for both hardware and software make the Phone 2 one of my favorite Android phones this year, and I didn't even talk about the great display, good performance, and okay cameras. The LTPO OLED display is 6.7 inches at 1080p with up to 1600 nits. I just wish the optical fingerprint reader was half an inch higher. The Snapdragon 8 Plus Gen 1 is powering the Phone 2. It's not the latest chip, but performance and battery life are solid. With the 4700 mAh battery, I can get 5 hours of screen on time with about 20% battery remaining on the second day. The Phone 2 has a dual camera system, 50 megapixels for both the wide and ultra wide. The photos and videos are pretty decent in low lighting for a mid-range phone. I'm used to flagships, so I'm not going to complain. And in good lighting, I'm happy with the colors and detail. The Nothing Phone 2 stands out from the rest of the market in terms of design and software, and it puts it in my top 3 favorite smartphones of 2023. What do you think about the Phone 2? Let me know in the comments down below. Thanks for watching, and if you haven't already, please like, subscribe, and hit the bell so you'll be notified when I post new videos. And I'll catch you guys in the next one. Bye!